Data analyst interviews are not easy, especially the technical assessment. I've spent countless of hours preparing for these SQL interview questions, and today I'll be sharing with you my top tips, as well as walking you through a real SQL interview question at the end, so stay tuned. First of all, what is SQL? SQL is a way for data analysts to talk to databases. They use SQL to manipulate data, pull data, and aggregate it for data analysis. SQL is fundamental to data analysts as it's extremely scalable, and as companies work with big data, data analysts will heavily use SQL. How complex are these SQL interview questions for a data analyst? Well, you should know for your first role, a beginner to intermediate level. So beginner means you should know the select statements, be able to do joins, as well as filter the data. An intermediate level means you know how to aggregate the data as well as do subqueries. And the advanced level means you know how to do window functions and understand the data modeling concepts. And if you want to know the specific functions to know for an interview, I'll also list them right here so that you have a reference. Now let me walk you through a real data analyst interview question. I'll be using the platform Interview Query, who is today's sponsor, and I'm really excited to use their platform because I think it'll be super helpful to prepare you for the interview. So this is a typical format of a live coding interview. You'll have the question at the top and the tables listed below, along with the column header and the data type so that you can piece it together in the final output of what they expect to see. So the question here is, write a query to identify customers who placed more than 3 transactions each in both 2019 and 2020. And I see that there's a transactions table and a users table. So I'm assuming that in the transactions table, that I see an ID and that this is unique, as in there's not going to be the same ID listed in here twice, because that'll allow me to count the transactions. And then the users, I see that there's an ID and name. I'm gonna assume users is customers in here, and that the final output customer name is equal to the name in the user table. And then I'm assuming that the ID from users can be joined onto the transactions table on user ID from transactions, and that the created at, because I see that this is the only date in here, I'm assuming that this is a date I'll use to filter on 2019 and 2020. So these are some of the assumptions I'll be making and asking for clarification. And so if I'm pulling from the transactions table, what I'm going to do is I'll do a inner join onto the users table on user ID that I had confirmed equals b.id. So the reason why I'm using an inner join is because I only want to include the users that have transactions and the transactions that have users. So if it falls outside of that, that's okay. I'll use the where, the year of the created at is in 2019 and 2020, because I only want to include these years, the 2019-2020, and I will start pulling the information that I'll need from the select statement. So I'm going to need the customer ID. I also want to know the username. So that'll be b.name as the customer name, because that's the final output. But then I also need to get the year of the transactions, because what I'm going to do here is I'm going to count the number of transactions as transaction count. Action count. So I'm counting the transactions per year for each customer is what this query does. And then I will have to do a group by to do a count. So I'm going to group by the customer, the ID name and create it at, and then having the, let's see, count ID, having this count, so having a count greater than 3. So I'm going to filter the data to give me the transaction count greater than 3 per year by customer is what this result will give me. And what I need to do is now pull, because the final output is just the customer name, I need to pull just the customer name from this result. So this is a subquery. And I can also use a CTE in here as well. And this will give me the customer name from this result. And that is what they're asking for. So the customers who placed more than 3 transactions each in both 2019 and 2020. So let me delete all these comments so it doesn't mess it up. And then I will run this and let's see. So it says my output. Oh, so my output has duplicates because I'm pulling both 2019 and 2020. There's going to be multiple rows. And what I need to do is remove these duplicates because the final output should only be these 2 rows. So what I can do here is just add a group by the customer name, and that will remove the duplicates. You could also use a distinct in here and not use a group by, and that will get you the same result as well. So let me remove group by and then submit, and let's see if that works. Yay. Okay, so what I like about this platform is that if you scroll to the bottom, you can see that there's way more different ways to solve the same problem. I did it using a subquery at the top, but you can see other people just did it using a case when statement. So there's really a lot of opportunities to learn using this platform, and I think it would be really useful if you're getting ready and preparing for a SQL data analyst interview. Now, if you did find this video helpful, please like and subscribe, as I do have another interview video coming up that I am very excited about. And if you want to learn more about how to write a data analyst resume, I'll link the video here so that you can get started. Thank you so much, and I can't wait to see you there.